If you got poop on your arm, would you just wipe it with dry paper? No, you'd wash it with water. That's exactly what a bidet does, but for your butt. It washes your butt with a fresh stream of water, leaving you clean and confident to take on your day. And that's why so many people from all around the world have embraced the bidet and washed their butts after pooping. But the real question is, why don't Americans use bidets? And that's what we're uncovering today. To figure out the answer to why Americans don't use bidets, we gotta go back in time to the very first bidets found in France. And even Napoleon had a silver-lined bidet that he'd bring with him all over the world on his travels. The word bidet itself is a French word, and it literally means small pony. And the reason it means small pony is because those early bidets, you would actually have to straddle your legs over the bidet like you were riding a pony and actually scoop the water from the basin to wash your private parts. As you can imagine, bidets started out only being for royalty and the upper class, but then in the 19th century, when we adopted indoor plumbing, more and more people could have bidets in their homes and establishments. And just like how all good news travels far and wide, the bidet spread from France to other parts of Europe and even to Eastern Asia, the Middle East, and South America. And even now, some people's most memorable moments from travel are when they see and use bidets in Japan, Italy, Portugal, Venezuela, or Argentina, just to name a few. I mean, you've probably seen or at least heard about the electric bidets in Japan with all the different wash settings, and they even blow dry your butt. Another really cool thing about Japan is that 80% of all bathrooms have bidets. So with the popularity of bidets all around the world, why the heck are Americans not washing their butts? Here is why. As you know, America started out as British colonies. It's also really well known that 18th century Britain disdained the decadent and hedonistic lifestyle of the French aristocracy. And it is believed that when the Britons came over, became American colonies, that they took some of those opinions with them.
Yeah,
I know that was a long time ago. However, modern Americans were reintroduced to the bidet in Europe during World War II in brothels. And so even though the soldiers were introduced to the bidet as patrons of the brothels, they associated it with immorality and sex work. And that's just not fair. They turned the bidet into this dirty, shameful thing when in actuality it was cleaning you up. And remember, during this time, Americans were happily using their beloved white toilet paper to clean up after pooping, and this was just the American way of life. And in fact, America popularized toilet paper all around the world. In the 1960s, a man named Arnold Cohen created the American Bidet Company, and he installed thousands of seats across New York and in offices in different parts of the country as well. But due to the stigma around bidets, no one would even buy them or try them or even let him place ads for them. That's just sad. Can you imagine? We were so close to having cleaner butts all across America. And the story ends with Arnold Cohen licensing his patent for his bidet seat to Toto Company, which, as you probably know, they've popularized electric bidet seats all around the world. And another reason why Americans don't have bidets in their bathroom is because there simply isn't enough space for a separate bidet basin. And the main reason why Americans haven't adopted the bidet is because of culture and habit. Us Americans, we sure do love to use our beloved white toilet paper. And as soon as it became popularized in the 1800s, we were addicted, and this was how life was. And this is how life is currently for most Americans. And also, Americans are generally much more conservative, and we don't really talk about anything bathroom related. Girls don't even fart. Just kidding, we do. So even if you did have a friend that used a bidet, it's unlikely that they would be willing to chat about it openly. And I actually have a personal hunch that most Americans don't either know about bidets or haven't ever thought about using one. And that, my friends, is just so sad because there's a much better way to clean after pooping. And that's why we're making this video, and that's why we're spreading the word. And luckily, bidets have evolved over the years, and you no longer need separate plumbing or space for a separate basin. You have the modern bidet attachment. And this one is the TUSHY bidet attachment spa model, and it simply attaches between your toilet bowl and your toilet seat, and it washes your booty with a fresh stream of water. And in fact, this is tap water, so it's the same water that you brush your teeth with or you wash your face with. And so we've got two models. Like I said, this one is the spa version, so you can actually have temperature control, which means you have the option to wash your booty with warm water as well. But there's so many other benefits of a bidet. It helps you save money, it saves the planet because you decrease your toilet paper usage by like 80%, and it's just much better for your health, and it can help prevent issues like hemorrhoids, anal fissures, UTIs, or even yeast infections. So you guys, we've been talking about bidets and really trying to get Americans to adopt them for years at Tushy, and so it's finally time. We believe people are finally starting to listen and to maybe get a little curious about bidets, and that's why we created this video, and that's why you're here right now. So if you are interested in learning more about Tushy or the benefits of bidets, check out some of the videos recommended at the end of this one, and you can go to hellotushy.com/vlog to get your very own Tushy bidets. We want to invite you to join our community hosted on Facebook groups. It's a collective of pooping humans just like you and me from all around the world sharing our bidet experiences and sharing tips and advice on having a healthier gut, butt, and just life in general. So definitely join us in there, and we hope to see you. Happy pooping, y'all. I'll see you next time.